Howdy, it's me, Manic Mark, coming to you from the bunker system located underneath the Artville. I found somewhere in the jungles of the Midwest. It's the Manic Mark quasi-reality show. It's always real, but the contents may not be always real. Because I get things messed up and I have to go upstairs. It's like, why did I say that? That can't be. Then it is. Never mind. Anyway, a Merry Christmas, for God's sakes. People aren't going crazy around here, it seems like. It's pretty smooth. Everything's pretty smooth. Going along pretty smooth. Got a tree upstairs. It's been a long time since I've been here. Let's just start off. I have no plans. That's why. Well, I have a couple plans. I'll just jump right into the planned stories here in a minute. Records. That's right. Haven't been here in a long time, and I've just got a thin stack of records. Still, it's become more increasingly difficult to find records. All right, because I think everything's so popular, people are just looking for them. All right. Plus, don't say that anymore. What? All right. That's right. All right. Well, let me start with this story. It's Christmas a little bit early around here at the Art Villa. There's a reason for that, but let's just say I got socks, and you think, oh, that's like the classic, socks and underwear and ties. Who wants any of that? Well, you know, with modern day underwear, it can be pretty good. It can be pretty good stuff, modern day underwear. Fabrics are so much better than when we were growing up. You know, it's like, oh, boxer shorts or jockey, they're both cotton and they both kind of were uncomfortable and crumpled up and just weren't back in the olden days, you know. So let me tell this story. No, let me hold off on that. I'll forget it anyway. Because I held off on it just long enough, like a second, to go right out of my head. So, a few Christmas gifts early, and I was given socks by my brother. And I said, you'd like, oh, socks. Well, geez, I got a drawer full of them. And that's, you know, they were stripedy, stripedy socks, and you know, the collars were not kind of nice, but I'm like, yeah. But I've been wearing running shoes a lot now, and not boots and stuff like that, kind of shifting, everything's shifting, it's in flux, shifting. And I put this, because I spent a lot of time out of the house the past few days outside, so I put the socks on. So anyway, they were amazing. The socks were so amazing. I want to throw all the socks that I currently own away and fill the drawer full of the socks that I was given. But they're very pricey, probably because they're just really amazing socks. You wouldn't think socks could, especially in the winter. They're good for winter. It's a smart wool, darn tough socks out of Vermont. Okay, and it's called Merino. I don't know if that's the name of a wool or a type of wool, a brand or a type, or anyway, a certain kind of quality of wool. But it's a blend. It's got it's 61% wool. It's got 2% nylon, elastane. Okay, 61%. Oh my God, LAINE. 32% nylon and 2% elastane. I guess it's. That doesn't add up to 100%, so there must be like two things working together in tandem here. Anyway, much of it's wool, and then there's man-made stretchy fibers in it, but it just doesn't itch. They feel great. They breathe. They don't stink. They mold your feet just great. They keep your feet warm in the tennis shoes in the winter. Boy, I could go on, and I did, about socks. Okay, it's enough with the socks. So the other gift I got... okay, I'll back up. I said, did I say, see, I've spent so long, I don't know even what was in my last video. Did I say I did my 6-mile run? I said I was going to do a 6-mile run on my birthday. Well, my brother came up for my birthday, and I thought, well, my brother comes up for my birthday, how can I possibly have time to run my 6 miles? Because I fully expected to run the 6 miles and just, like, crap out, man, and be completely done. So So there was kind of, it wasn't a real warm day, but it was okay. It wasn't, you know, it was kind of windy and dry, a bit. The sun came out a little bit, but nonetheless, I felt good. An exact 3 mile loop. I got a 3 mile loop, and I did the first 3 miles, which I said, you know, oh no, I'll be in front of the house after 3 miles. Then I'll just want to go in and lay down anyway and drink a beer. So I have to force myself to run by the house. Well, I did, and I did the whole thing. I felt great. I ran the whole thing pretty hard, an hour and a half, thereabouts. That's what the wife said. And then we went out and got something to eat. I mean, I was fine. It's great. I'll put this photograph up. Now, if I were to put the photograph up, you're seeing it again. Then you're like, oh yeah, that's right. He told the story because you may be more visual. So anyway, oh, that leads to this story, which is the big Mandy Mark gift for this year is the Fitbit. So my wife gives me a Fitbit. And I did mention smartwatches. I kind of looked at them, and I'm like, but only because I wanted to be able to GPS some of my jogging routes, which are not on the road or difficult to get a sense of what I'm actually doing when I run. Some of the paths are in parks, and you can't possibly use a car or any other way to, get close to it. So I thought about it, but I thought, well, you know, I'll just get kind of tired of it. They're kind of expensive, and I never even thought of the Fitbit. I didn't even know what it was. but that's what I got. So I spent like almost an hour when we opened it, gets like trying to like, oh no, the iPhone is too old, the new software won't work because the iPhone software is too old, so I got to get the old software and put it on the iPhone. But then if it's the old software, we'll connect with the new Fitbit. And then I got her a Kindle, okay, a new one, because she's had the 3 years on the old one, and I said, well, it's time, prices were pretty good. And then you gotta try to hook that up. Well, what's your password? I don't know. Like, oh, geez, oh no. Well, it'll be so simple. We'll just say forget password, and we'll go through the couple of steps to get the new password. Except the link that Amazon sends you, you go to the page, and it doesn't work. It doesn't work. So then I gotta go to my desktop, go through the desktop, which is a different path, and send it. And it sends an email to the old Kindle, which then I get that. Link and go to the page to verify. Then there's the anyway, and then setting up email. Oh Lord, just shoot me in the head. I couldn't believe it. This is the last thing I could do before I shoot myself in the head, and it worked. So I didn't shoot myself in the head. All right. So how do you like this thing? Well, it measures steps. So there's like, during the day you just walk around, and if you wear it, some people wear them all the time, but I'm not going to do. I feel more connected to the hive now. I feel more like doing everything that everybody else does and not getting in trouble and making sure everything, because you know, like the Matrix hive deal, never mind. But in a way, it's kind of like, you know, you're plugging yourself into the grid, man, pretty good with this thing. So it syncs with your desktop, right? I mean, because you got it measures all your steps and your heart rate throughout the day. And this is interesting. And then you can time your workouts, and you can use the GPS with the phone. So if you go someplace, like jogging, you have to carry the phone. So it's not like something I would do all the time, but maybe once, just, you know, map her out, whatever. It just adds another layer of interest to, you know, I can't say exercise is drudgery, but it's very hard, and sometimes you really don't want to be doing that last 15 minutes. If you know you're competing with your wife for steps every day, then you might do the extra 15 minutes. I've caught her in the bathroom, in the kitchen, running in place, trying to beat me, Manic Mark, on steps. That's right. It's like a secret, like compulsive stepper now. And I noticed today I did an hour of yoga. I did half an hour of weights, I did half an hour on the stationary bike, and I did a half an hour on a rowing machine, and the damn thing doesn't count steps. I did all that exercise, and I don't get a whole lot of damn steps. So she's going to come like, hey, how many steps you got? I'm like, oh, probably by that time 8,000. She'd be all like, I got 12,000. I don't know if our marriage will survive the Fitbit. the competition. Anyway, so why was Christmas early this year? Well, now you got to bring it down again. Remember the Mr. Burns story? Well, it's this is not something that just, you know, it's been an ongoing thing, and it's public, so don't think like, oh, why even talking about that, because that seems like something you just probably wanted just to be a family matter. But you know, my brother put it out there on his own, so it's not going to be any secret. I'm not going to go into any detail, but you've got a rare form of cancer that's probably terminal. Well, you always want to hold out a little thing of hope, but the first round of everything didn't really take, and so anyway, we had a Christmas together a whole week, birthday and Christmas, and it was great. It was great. We talked about a whole bunch of stuff that probably you only talk about when, you know, you're shoved into a corner. And it got along real well. So it was good to see him. Anyway, he gave me the socks. That's where I got the socks, the fabulous socks. I bought a six pack. I bought a box of them. I think there were six of them. There's six or four? Six. Six, I think. So I got kind of a discount. Still a lot of money, but they're just a damn nice, darn tough Vermont socks that I went ahead and ordered the bulk pack. All right, so he's gone back to whence he came from, which is way far to visit. And for me, Manic Mark, homebody Manic Mark, and Mrs. Manic Mark, we don't go anywhere. So it was nice for him to make the effort to come up here. There you go. Okay, let's go on to the records. The records, you were going to tell a story and forgot about it. What the hell was it? Oh, well, no, that wasn't it. It was, house insurance. No, that's not it. House insurance. No, I'm not talking about that. See, I told you I would forget about it. Anyway, records. I ordered two records off of eBay, and the shipping was $4 in first class, but nobody that sells records sends records anything but media mail. So here's the person, $4 a piece. You go, you add them to your cart, and you request a total. Well, normally people give you a shipping discount, like combined shipping, especially in records. So it's like combined shipping, semi-total. He sends me the total, like $8 in first-class shipping. So I pay for it, and again, like, no shipping discount? Nothing! And you could tell he doesn't sell a lot of records because of the way he shipped them to me. They got here safe, but I didn't come here to complain about that. I probably got another complaint that I just can't think of what it is. So, what the hell? I knew I would forget about it. I just knew it. I'm going to cut out. If I cut something out, it's because I'm sitting here going, I can't remember anything. Okay. It's 20th century American music. It's contemporary, American contemporary music. The Samuel Alder IV String Quartet, the Pro Arti, 1968, to the best wishes. Say, oh, it's autographed. Oh, wow, he didn't even mention that in his description. Samuel Alder, one of the artists, Herbert Frohman, and Samuel Alder, signed the back. Sam, 1968, at a concert. That's pretty awesome. So I guess I won't complain. I was just so wanted to complain about that guy. I won't do it now. It's the Art of Art. It's a reissued collection of Art Tatum's 1953 and 1955 Art Tatum recorded 100 notes. It's not there's not 100 tunes on this, and it's between then he recorded a lot of music, and apparently they've reprocessed the mono into stereo and put it on this set, which was released when, I have no idea. Go on, okay. It's a Twist record, Chubby Checker. There's a million of those, I probably wouldn't pick it up, but I've never seen this one, Chubby Checker. Let's limbo some more. He made a limbo record. Well, yeah. You out there, all out there, like the Twist. So you're going to like the limbo too. There's some great titles. But anyway, it was a fun cover. Jazz, Samba, Encore with Stan Getz and Luis Bonifa. Oh, Manic Mark, you got this one, do I? It's a jazz record on Verb. An antique store. I found a few stuck in a dealer's booth that were reasonably priced, a few records, picked them up. New music for Virtuosos. Virtuosos, that's right. It's American Contemporary. Once again, American Contemporary. I think I have this one, but I'm not sure. I could have one, but I don't know. So I picked it up again. I remember this cover too, but for a dollar, it was worth picking up again. The Emerson String Quartet. Blah 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 blah. American Contemporary. Basically, that's orchestrated avant-garde kind of stuff. When you hear somebody talk about that, this ain't worth nothing. But I thought maybe it would be, and it's kind of worn out. Probably shouldn't have picked it up. It looked kind of weird, like psychedelic, kind of. It's probably all on YouTube, doesn't matter. This looks like fun on Palace Records, which is just like a super budget. Like, don't buy anything on that label, you'll be sorry. It's a surf record, a surf knockoff, a surf exploitation record, if that's possible, with the Sunsets. It's just sort of probably a made-up studio. And last but not least, picked up from the $4 first class shipping guy. See, he shipped these records in the jackets. This one looks like it was already, the spine was already ripped, but you know. Picked it up because of the cover. It's the Duke, the Blues, Billy Eckstein, and me. Me, it's probably that woman on the front cover. Do they give her any credit for being, you know, some kind of human being or something? Like, hey, what's your name? They got a woman, her eyes match her outfit. You didn't Photoshop things back then. So her eyes, in fact, do match her outfit, and they had to, like, get the outfit to match her eyes. Marketing and art and production was so much more complicated back in the day. So now I just think I'll sit here and try to remember that. The other story I was going to tell you and I didn't tell you, because I couldn't remember it. It's just so sad that I forget things the way I do. Doodly 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 doo doodly 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 doo 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 doo. So I start talking about going there, going to Christmas dinner, going out, everything we did, went out to eat. So in Covington, this means nothing to anyone because if you don't know Covington, you don't know. But they took an old department store and the city hall was in it and it was falling apart. And somebody poured some money into it and turned a seven-story business that used to be a building that used to be a department store into a hotel in the middle of Covington, which was always like, I've been here 30 years, like, yeah, Covington. But it's just like you're walking into some place that's not, can't be found in Covington. And a lot of other big buildings around the area are getting rehabbed. Covington's kind of exploding. Finally, sort of exploding. And they're going to rip out this IRS thing that's down by the river, you know, when they had to cart all your woe and misery around, you know, on the first floor with little wheels. I got a whole cart full of woe and misery, you know, your taxes. Or carting them around. Well, they did all do it digital now, and they could just stack desks one on top of each other. They don't need to take up prime real estate along the river, so they're going to tear that building out and probably build something really horrible there. They built one nice building downtown. It's like a big art swoopy thing, like some kind of like bent spear or something. It's condominiums. It's a big, huge building. It was a big uproar over it because it wasn't just, oh, it's not square. Nobody likes it because it's not square, red, made out of red brick. But I always liked it. It's pretty awesome. You got to think a building like that leaks because it's like, oh, the Frank Lloyd Wright buildings or whatever, you know. It's like, wow, they look great, but the poor maintenance staff is running around all the time like with buckets trying to, you know, just leaking. My friend was telling me that squirrels eat lead. So when they trim windows in lead, the squirrels will find them in each of the lead that trim your gaskets right out of your windows. It's amazing. I didn't know that. Why would a squirrel love? Maybe they just love the taste of lead, and then like, oh, can you imagine? They eat the lead, and then they try to jump up in the tree, and like, blop. They can't do it because they're full of lead. They're heavy. The squirrels are heavy. And squirrels don't need to be heavy because they climb trees. And that's probably a good ending. The squirrel story was probably a good ending. I'm going to have to spend a lot of time processing this stuff. I was just going to come home and take a nap. And here I am down here making my holiday video. That's the other thing. I'm not going to make 2 or 3 years in a row. I made the end of the year photograph thing. I'm not going to do it this time around because it's just extremely time-consuming, and I don't do time-consuming stuff anymore. Everything you do consumes time, right? But I'm not doing that anymore, okay? I'm not going to do it anymore. I know there'll be at least one person that'll be like, oh, I kind of look forward to that. And then there'll be another person will be like, no, I didn't like that. So that person will be happy, but the person to look forward to it will be... I won't know that they're unhappy because they won't let me know, but... Anyway. I still don't remember the flippin' story I was going to tell. Socks, Fitbit, running... I bought swim trunks, that's right. This is a good story. I bought swim trunks and I spent a lot of time researching pool shoes, and they were like, oh, these fall apart like after the first time you use them. So I got some like really good pool shoes, made for climbing rocks and like more like what scuba divers might be interested in. So then I could get at the pool at the gym and run, you know, use the water's resistance and kind of keep all that weight off the knees and hips, which are still good. I can still do stuff, but you know. So like, what kind of swim trunks? Well, I didn't want the bag. I got baggy ones. And sometimes I saw like an old guy. He must have been 80, so he had like the really tight Speedos on, but they came down to his knees like bike shorts. So I'm only 60, so I figured I didn't need to go all the way down to my knees with kind of like Speedos down to your knees. So I got the square cut ones, which aren't really, you know, too awkward to wear for my age, I don't think. Hope not. Oh, it's like just, you come out of the locker room, it's like, oh, you know, I'm going to wear a shirt. And you kind of dive right in immediately, right as you come out, you can dive in to the pool area, you know. So you're not, the bright light's like, oh, geez, you know, I'm old and white and,
insensatez que você fez, coração.